what we did is, in our movie, there's another evolution that happens with zombies, where this idea of what we would become if the zombie plague made us stronger, as opposed to decomposing.
I've never seen a movie that goes into the essence of zombies in this way.
Zach did a great job in a way to give zombies more human behavior back with Zeus and the Queen, because they just want to survive. That's crazy, yeah. New species, oh my God.
You have alpha zombies that are like superheroes. They have superhero qualities, you have superhuman qualities.
And that's where the game changes, right? Because it's not something that moves as fast, it moves faster, has more agility. It's almost like a cheetah in the way it moves. That raises the fear level to an entirely new place.
We use like really great stunt performers to beat them. So whatever the scariest stunt man can do, they can do. When you actually see that, what that means, it's pretty scary.
Our stunt coordinator, Damon, who is a legend in the game, did a hell of a job rounding up some of the greatest parkour cats, martial artists, free runners. It's just amazing what these guys are able to do.
You can imagine if like a wolf had a human body, like how they would act. They're predators in the end. So they're hunting. There's an alpha and there's a way of like organizing them through intimidation.
Zach wanted the alphas look to be different, but yet they still had to look like they were in the same world. So that's quite challenging.
We wanted to do something that's really translucent, something that's more feral and aggressive, something that's alert and aware of what's going on, opposed to your classic zombie that is just stumbling around, rotting away.
We went through a process where we would talk to Justin and his artists, would then go sketch out some things.
We went through a lot of different variations in design with Zach. We want to give him as many Photoshop options and 3D model options as possible, so we can really hone in on what the final looks will be. We did that with the Shamblers and all the other alphas as well.
It was this really nice back and forth collaboration until we came up with our design for the alpha.
And then we start going into the sculpting process. We really kind of started looking at translucent shrimp, weird aquatic kind of things to get that look to the flesh. I think Zeus is the perfect example of what the alpha should look like. He's the most evolved in this process. He's the essence of that look. So Zeus originally started around 3.5 hours to do the look. Now we have him in under 2, and that's 3 makeup artists putting on those 24 prosthetic pieces. Queen is a little closer to Zeus, let's say, got a little more of the essence from Zeus. So she's a little more evolved compared to some of our other alphas. She is also about 22 prosthetic pieces. So she's silicone prosthetics on her arms, silicone prosthetic across chest, face, full wig, contact lenses, teeth. The Queen decapitation had a lot of moving parts, from a full fake body to an insert body that we actually used with the garrote to cut the head off.
Even if you go like, come on!
Yeah,
okay.
Like a little like...
Yeah, there you go.
And then a complete animatronic head.
It's a radio-controlled hand, has jaw and swine, eyes left right up down, okay. And then some metal snarl, tracking eyelids.
So she's really the only full animatronic piece that we had. So 2 puppeteers to run it, a lot of mechanical aspects, and then functioning traditional practical effects gags and blood gags. We have a very large crew. We have 35 makeup artists, and that'll be about 6.5 hours to run 150 alphas through the works with Zeus, Queen, Zeus double, and the General. We've been able to keep it really, really tight.
Just to be enveloped by hundreds and hundreds of alphas and Zeus and the Queen and being in their like realm, literally their kingdom, to have to be dragged in there as a human and to be pulled in while you're laying on this cold floor and there's hundreds and hundreds of zombies and they're all growling at you and spitting blood and yelling. It just is incredibly frightening. The coolest thing was seeing all these hundreds of zombie extras react to him. Like every time he does something or he lashes or he snarls, they do the same. This is now probably subliminally what he always wanted. I just don't know if he wanted it like this. And now he truly is this just unstoppable force, which I think he always thought he was.
I think the end result is definitely unique. It's something that I don't feel like I've seen in this type of genre. It just has an ethereal quality to it.
So it was this fun experiment with like everything we've kind of done around the alphas. It's really fun to see how scary they can be.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the Netflix Film Club channel to get our latest exclusive videos. Plus, hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.